And oh, Bill may lapse into a loss. The much anticipated security of 10 years, SOT, still awaiting President Uter's signature may yet lapse into a loss. The bill, whose Senate version was adopted by the House of Representatives, was transmitted to Malassanem on June 27. It will lapse into law if not acted upon by the President by July 27. On the other hand, Mr. Uter is likely anticipated to take up the so-called MO, end of contractualization, bill by Monday, July 22, when he delivers his fourth State of the Nation address. A coalition of business groups has urged the President to veto the bill for being redundant, citing laws that protect workers from illegal contractualization. Of course, the President is always appreciated and considerate on whatever opposition or concerns raised by any sector in this country relative to any bill passed in Congress and subject to his signature or veto, says presidential spokesperson Salvador Pamlo. There are so many documents he has to sign, and at the same time, he has so many activities he has to attend to. Out-of-town trips, he visits one place, and then another place. Meanwhile, documents pile up. So sometimes, he doesn't get to see all of them, he also said. Earlier, Labor Secretary Silvester Bellogree said he hoped the President would sign the bill, as ensuring workers' SOT is one of Mr. Uter's priorities. Among the groups calling for a presidential veto of the bill are Makati Business Club, Management Association of the Philippines, Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry and Semiconductors and Electronics Industries in the Philippines Foundation Incorporated, Mortals, for his part, Trade Union Congress of the Philippines, Chuck, Brett. Raymond Mendoza said in a statement it was truly reprehensible for business groups to call for the bill's rejection. We prefer the proposed left square bracket SOT right square bracket law be signed by the President rather than remain silent while the employers and economic managers, not satisfied in stamping out the intent of the bill, cannot even give a few morsels to the workers, he said. Mendoza said that while the CUP was keenly aware that the bicameral process on the SOT bill was short-circuited, it still considered the proposed law as a good start. The proposed SOT law is at court by practically all employers because it categorically prohibits labor-only contracting. It provides a far clearer definition of what labor-only contracting is, including the business of mere recruitment and placement of workers, he said. Slash AC, thank you for watching. Please subscribe.